David Eckstein, a World Series MVP, is a spark plug for the San Diego Padres.
I love being in the situation when the game's on the line.
Off the field, a love story of how his Hollywood stars align.
When you meet or even just watch David Eckstein play, you immediately feel his positive aura and energy, his enthusiasm for life. Learn his background and you understand why he beat the odds to become a big leaguer, how his family's health crises have made him a man on a mission. And then there's the Cinderella story of how he met his actress wife. But we begin with chapter one, David Eckstein, the underdog.
Right off the bat.
Eck to right, base hit, this one's tied.
Let's get the pronunciation of his name correct.
Definitely, it is Eckstein. Yeah, it's a German lineage.
That's Eckstein, like Einstein. Of course, physicist Albert Einstein is famous for his theory of relativity, and specifically E equals mc squared. Look it up, and the formula implies that any small amount of matter contains a very large amount of energy. A patent description of David Eckstein.
Oh, diving stop, Eckstein!
Small but mighty.
Grabs it!
In the field.
He just does everything right. Everything.
And at the plate.
Eck swings! Hits it to left, fading in the corner, and it is gone! Eck has tied it up!
After being named the MVP of the 2006 World Champion St. Louis Cardinals, he co-wrote a book called Have Heart. Its tone is more for youngsters. Its message, in his own words, good for any age.
I stand just 5'7". Some little leaguers are taller than me. Some baseball people said, I'll never play in the major leagues. It's true that I don't hit many home runs. I'm not the fastest on the field, and my arm is just strong enough. However, I always had the desire to be the best baseball player I could be since I was old enough to hold a bat. I never gave up, and I never lost heart.
David Mark Eckstein was born January 20th, 1975 in Sanford, Florida, a fighter from the beginning. As a baby, he didn't gain weight because of a blockage in his stomach. Emergency surgery saved his life, and as he writes, the scar is a constant reminder of the miracle of life and how blessed I am to be alive.
I was very fortunate. I had two great parents.
His parents, Whitey and Pat.
That doesn't seem so easy.
Then she heard him interviewed after the Angels won the World Series.
He was talking about his morals and values, and I remember watching it thinking, yeah, my friends are right. I think I would get along with him. He seems like a cool guy. But again, they just won the World Series. So I'm like, oh yeah, right. Like now there's no way I can meet this guy. So I just brushed it off. About a year and a half later, I ended up going to an Angels game. And this is the part of the story that he doesn't like me telling because...
Now you want to hear it.
No, of course.
Her friend bought her an Eckstein shirt to wear in their front row seats.
Whenever he made a great play or he got a hit, it was just like, oh, hey, that's your boy. And about halfway through the game, one of the Angels had scored. And I was just looking over at the commotion, and David happened to look over, and we made eye contact. And we locked eyes for about 5 seconds. That's the part he doesn't want me to tell, because it sounds like he broke focus.
It was something that I was very disappointed in myself, that it made an impression on me. So,
yeah, and it wasn't like it was like this romantic thing.
No.
6 weeks later, she needed a date to the premiere of an independent movie. And in true Hollywood fashion, her publicist contacted the Angels Media Relations Director, who suggested that David call her.
Because in the email, they described her as angelic.
But he wouldn't go to the premiere on Thursday without meeting her first.
I go, there's no way. I wasn't really the Hollywood type.
Yeah.
The one day they could meet, that Monday. This is where it gets magical, based on her fourth grade teacher's comment.
I've been waiting ever since I was 10 for my golden birthday because he told me something special would happen. And it turns out that Monday was September 22nd, my 22nd birthday, and he was number 22.
A month into their dating, she revealed they had seen each other earlier that summer.
He goes, understand this, the only reason I remember it is because that's the first time I've ever looked into the stands, and I was so mad at myself.
Regardless.
We're two peas in a pod, I guess you could say.
Ashley adores Alice in Wonderland, so
date to be together.
And with children in their enchanted equation someday, You can imagine there will be lots of bedtime stories, including his own.
Reflecting on my life and the struggles my family has endured, I am reminded to cherish every moment and to persevere no matter what. That is why I play so hard. It is what having heart is all about. It means that no matter what happens, no matter what curveball life may throw you, you never lose faith. You never lose respect for yourself or others. And you never lose the belief that every second of your life is worth giving the best effort you can. It's all about having heart.